El Paso, Texas, a city with a population of approximately 600,000 citizens. And as it continues to grow, more problematic situations increase, such as disorders like bulimia. Amongst these high schools are where most of the issues are found. Nobody knows what happens behind closed doors, but what we do know is that according to MySouthern Health, statistically there were 8 million Americans that were diagnosed with eating disorders.
In this documentary, we're here to find out how many students and citizens of El Paso, Texas are well aware of an eating disorder called bulimia nervosa. So we interviewed a few people and asked them, do you know what bulimia is?
Is?
No.
No?
An eating disorder?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes?
I've heard of it, but I don't know what it is.
You.
Yes, I do.
Mm-hmm. No.
No?
Not really.
Yes.
No.
One of our interviewers, who was actually a teacher at ASIC High School, a health teacher, was able to give us the best possible answer.
A little bit.
Can you explain in your words?
Is bulimia how they get sick? In the eating disorder,
mm-hmm.
when they're not eating very good, their health deteriorates and they get lose weight more than they want to, and they think it's a great thing, but it can cause a lot of health complications.
Yes, and there's more to it. Actually, bulimia also goes with the fact that when a person feels guilty and they tend to eat a lot, so they binge eat, but therefore will throw it back up in order to stay.
So then they get a lot of when they do throw up and stuff like that, they get heart.
Yes, because of
and that's a reflex situation. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes. Okay. Since you said yes, where have you heard of this before?
Kind of know about it because I've had a few of my students within time, or had that complication in their life, and a lot of it sometimes is stress, sometimes it's genetic where they see somebody else in their family do it, but a lot of times it's just. And their own thinking that they don't, their appearance is not well enough, they're gonna try to do a quick fix on losing weight.
That is true.
We also did a survey online and we got about 100 respondents. And out of those 100 respondents, 39% didn't know what bulimia was, 32% didn't know, and 28% someone knew.
As a quick recap, bulimia is when somebody goes through cycles of binging and purging at least once a week for 3 months, but are typically still normal weight or overweight.
According to healthtopia.net, some physical signs are, of course, purging, doing excessive and tough exercises or fasting to get rid of calories, scars and signs on the knuckles known as Russell signs, swelling in the cheeks, and eyes may also have broken vessels.
But these factors play a role. They're terrified of gaining weight, they are obsessed with losing weight, and they're never happy with their bodies, even though they...
As we interviewed them, we went ahead and asked them who they think is mostly diagnosed with bulimia, women or men?
From male and female, who do you think is more diagnosed with bulimia?
Female.
You're right.
From male to female, who do you think is more diagnosed with bulimia?
Female.
Female?
I would say female teens.
Who do you think is more diagnosed?
I think females.
With bulimia.
Girls.
Girls? Male and female, who do you think is diagnosed more with bulimia?
Females.
Female?
Males and male teens, who do you think is more diagnosed?
Females.
Who do you think is more diagnosed?
I think females, but because they're more open about their feelings and guys like to hide what they feel.
All of our interviewers were quick to answer female, and even with our survey online, most of the people picked women as the person to be mostly diagnosed with bulimia. So how can we help?
You said people like insecure about their bodies, right? You guys should feel like tell them that they are.
Yeah, like try to hide them up, like on the like.
But how do you know who?
Exactly. Okay.
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe take them to some classes or something.
To help people amongst our community is best said by Michigan Medicine Channel, presented by Daniel G.
Loved one with an eating disorder, how can I best help them? The best approach is to take a caring, sympathetic tone to them and make sure that you can offer and assist them in terms of finding treatment that they need. Reminding them of the potential consequences of an eating disorder is also important.
Body shape, what you're eating. Eating disorders can actually harm the heart, the digestive system, the bones, the teeth, the mouth, and even lead to other diseases, other problems.
Don't even think about that. No, yeah.
Not
but
good.
With treatment, patients can return to healthier eating habits and sometimes reverse serious complications caused by that eating disorder.
Some of our interviewers also had something to say.
I think people who have that issue should speak up about it so they know there's more people also.
Think we can help teenagers who struggle with bullying?
Educating people about different eating disorders and how to deal with them and reach out to other people.
In what ways do you think we can help teenagers who struggle with bullying?
Get more people to know what it is and put more attention to it to help people understand and take better care of themselves.
Teenagers who struggle with bullying.
Try to make them feel more like confident with themselves and not try to make everyone be like, you have to look this way or this way.
I think we can help teenagers who struggle with bullying.
Well, I believe like always like the best thing to do is like speak out and talk to people who you're confident with. Mm-hmm. And maybe from there you can like step into stopping it.
In our survey online, our classmates shared their own ideas that can help. Key points that stood out to us are how we can inform people about all eating disorders, since plenty are only aware of anorexia. How words and bullying have a big part since it can mentally affect one's health. How schools should raise awareness and educate kids as young as middle schoolers. And how social media should be a place to advocate since that is where most issues can start. Our purpose for this video isn't only to inform you about an eating disorder, but to encourage each one of you to take action. Any disorder shouldn't be taken lightly, and it is our job as a community to help one another, encourage one another, and let everybody know we are part of the same world.
Now you might be asking yourself, but how can I help? Well, I'm here to tell you the ways in which you can help a close friend, or people you might not even know that may suffer from bulimia, or any type of disorder. If you want to know how someone is doing, you have to see them first. You have to see how they might see themselves. It doesn't hurt to ask someone how they may be doing. Secondly, if you find out that they have bulimia, it's okay to be surprised. Use your words wisely and find out ways to encourage them to do the right thing and get help. Remember that they struggle a lot with their appearance, mostly from feeling body shamed. Most importantly, I urge you to be aware of the symptoms and don't be afraid to lend a hand. You never know whose life you might be saving.